Hello, my name is Jay, and for this video I want to show you how to write a Python script to move all the files from a folder and as well as its all subdirectory folders into a target folder. So over here I have my move files folder. In this folder I have this access cookbook lessons, and this is basically all my lesson materials files. But I want to merge all the files into one place. So as you can see, now I have 18 chapters. And so in each chapter folder, I have multiple files. And I have like multiple access files. In chapter 2, I have 11 lesson files. And I don't want to do this by hand. If I do this by hand, I need to copy, cut, and paste 18 times. As you can see, I have 18 lessons. If I were trying to move all the files, I need to do it 18 times. And so that's why I want to use Python script to just write a simple program and to automate this process for me. And to do that, let's open your Python environment. And I'm using Sublime Text. So the only module that we need is the OS module. Let me change my syntax to Python 3. And I'm going to create two variables. So one variable is called the targets folder. And the target folder will be the variable that contains the where the folder that you want to move the file to. So I want to move all my files to this move files folder. So I'll just copy and paste the directory. And I'm going to insert two double slash, and then I'm going to create another variable called source folder. So the source folder basically is the parent folder that you want to move all the files from. So now as well as its child folders. So and so I know that all my files are within the access cookbook lesson folder. So I'm just going to copy this directory. And going to paste over. Again, I'm going to insert two double slash to make the folder variable. And to move the folder, so I'm going to use the os.walk method. Based on the folder directory path you provide, you will basically loop to every single directory within the within the parent directory folder. So I know that my my folder path is the source folder. So the os.walk method will return three variables. So return the folder path and the folder directory and the file names. So I'm going to store all these outputs into these three variables. So path, dir, files variables. And I'm going to print the path and as well as the files variable to see what it looks like. So we don't need the directory variable because that basically just gives us the folder name. So we don't need that. And oops, yeah. So when save and execute, and this is the output. So the first one is just the parent folder directory path. And second line is just the subfolder directory, so which is chapter 1. And within the chapter 1 folder, and so the files is actually a list variable. So it actually contains all the file names. So 1-1.mdb. So if I go back to my folder, and if I just verify making sure that these are indeed all the folders are within the chapter 1 folder. And so yeah, so from lesson 1 to all the way to lesson 13. Actually there's a 17, oh, and here, sorry, in 17. So we know that we want to skip the files variable that contains no file. So we're saying that if files, so that's basically saying that if there's a value within this files variable, and I don't need the prints anymore. And so I want to loop every single files in the files variable. And the next, I want to check whether or not if the file exists in the target folder. So if there's multiple files that within the same name, and I just want to move the first file that is available. And so if there's a duplicate name, I'm just going to skip that file. So I'm going to use the os.path.isfile function. And so this will return whether or not if the file already exists, giving a folder path. And so the folder path will be the target folder variable plus the file. And column, actually it should be, so I'm going to insert the not condition. So saying that if this file in this from this folder does not exist, then I want to move the file. So to move the file, I'm just going to use the os.rename method, and it will be the the source file path and double slash plus the file, and this is the your target folder. So to target folder and plus the file, and that's it. So now if I will save and run this script, so save and run and finish. So if I open my folder, and so I mean right now I'm just going to each chapter folders. As you can see, all the chapter folders contains no files now. If I go back to my Access Cookbook lesson, and should go up, and as you can see, here are all my tutorial files that contains in the Access Cookbook lesson folder. Okay, and that's pretty useful. So now if I want to reuse this function, how would I do that? So I can, and for one thing, I can write a function. So to write a function to mimicking this utility functionality, so I'm going to create a function called move files. And I'm going, my first parameter will be source folder variable or input. And my second parameter will be the target folder. So this is basically where you want to move the files to. And try, so and accept. So I'm going to use the try accept to make sure that if this error, then I'm going to catch the error. So this exception error, I'm going to print the error message. And so we're going to apply the same concept now from this for 5 lines of code. So for path, directory and files in os.walk. And so your source folder parameter. And so if files exist, then for file in the files variable, so because the files variable is a list, and so want to, if the file does not exist already, and os.path that is file, and from the target folder parameter plus file, then want to move the file. So os should path plus double slash plus the file variable and to the target folder plus the file variable. And at the end, I'm going to print a message, and all files move. Okay, just give it a pretty simple message. And I'm going to save. I'm going to comment this out. Okay, now actually I'm going to give the function a try. So I'm going to delete all my lesson materials, and here I have the backup. So before I already made a backup, and I'm going to copy all this chapter backup folders back to my original folder. And that basically replace all the folders. And Now, if we go, we'll go back to the every single lesson chapter folder. As you can see now, all the lessons folders has all the files. So chapter 3 has 15 files. Okay. Now let me go back to my my script, and now if I were going to use the function, so I'm just going to use the function move files, and I'm just going to grab the folder path. Actually, I can just do this. Target folder, actually, source folder, and just grab the variable target folder. And now if I will save and run this file, so save and run, and I get this print message or file move. And now if I go back to my SS cookbook lesson and go back, it should go one more level up, move files. As you can see, all my files within the SS cookbook lesson folder is now relocated to the move files folder. So this is everything I want to cover in this video, and very simple program, very easy to write, but at the same time it has such powerful functionalities, especially if you work with documents a lot. I think this is going to be pretty useful to some of you guys. Again, thank you for watching, and if you found this video useful, please give my video a like and subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching, and I'll tell you guys soon. Bye bye.